Ibrahima Konate, big part of Liverpool progress that Pep Ligenders absolutely loves to see. The Ligenders files. Liverpool's assistant manager has offered a glimpse into the camp once again. Providing some great insight on Ibrahima Konate and more. Having been deprived of Liverpool content for so long, fans have an almost insatiable appetite for pre-season updates. Pep Ligenders and the club's in-house content team have kindly obliged in the form of a regular diary written by the assistant manager. The latest entry is packed full of interesting nuggets once again, not least on new signing Ibrahima Konate. As the only piece of business conducted by Liverpool in the window so far, Konate is naturally the focus of a lot of attention. The young centre-back looked colossal in pre-season photos next to Virgil van Dijk. The Dutchman unusually towers over pretty much anyone, but almost looked small next to his potential new defensive partner. Certainly, the pair will make an intimidating barrier for any opponents facing them down. Exactly if and when Van Dijk and Konate will feature as a pairing remains to be seen. There are plenty of others in the mix, including Joel Matip and Joe Gomez. Between the final stages of Van Dijk's rehabilitation and the desire to allow Konate bedding in period, it may be some time before the two actually take to the Anfield pitch together. However, Ligenders has provided a positive update in terms of Konate's adaptation to the Liverpool system. Ibo is doing really well. He comes from a different style, but there are some similarities and he has adapted well to what we want. You see him, he is really calm on the ball, he knows how to attack and when to step in when with the ball. When to play the outside pass, when to play the inside pass, when to switch the game. It is interesting that Ligenders referenced the similarities to RB Leipzig, the club from which Liverpool bought Konate. Michael Edwards and his team appear to be developing a particular affinity for the Red Bull stable of clubs, having previously acquired Takumi Minamino. Naby Keita, Sta and Sadio Mane either directly or indirectly from the Salzburg or Leipzig setups. In the case of Konate, the familiarity with a high line could ready him for first team action sooner rather than later. The team have been drilling defensive situations up against 8 attackers, with the defender still challenged to step up as high as possible. The focus of Leander's comments on the build elements of Konate's game are also telling. It is easy to focus on defensive attributes when discussing centre-backs. But Van Dijk is the ultimate example of a defender who has a huge impact on the attacking side of the game. Liverpool's offensive struggles in his absence illustrate the point. Clearly, the hope Liverpool is that Konate can offer similar benefits when it comes to progressing the ball. And providing opponents with another dimension to think about. In a previous diary entry, the assistant manager spoke about options everywhere being the key to offensive play. There appears to be a confidence that Konate can add to that. Beyond Konate, Leanders discussed the progress of Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. He is another who could add something to the options everywhere philosophy, having been unable to make any kind of mark last season. This was partly due to his injury problems, and partly due to the fact that Liverpool found themselves in a crucial period upon his return. Jurgen Klopp could not risk too much tinkering with the team as the side made a monumental pull for the Champions League places. Now the reset button has been pushed in Austria, the former Arsenal man could yet have a big impact in the future. Leanders had this to say about the 27-year-old. I also have to highlight that Ox has scored some absolute world-class in training in these last few days, and you absolutely love to see it. Liverpool have been lacking a specialist long-range shooter since the departure of Philippe Coutinho. Oxlade-Chamberlain has previously showcased the value of such an asset against Manchester City. And if he can bring his world yes to the table in the Premier League, then it gives the team an extra option, especially against opponents determined to sit deep. Joel Matip was also singled out for special praise by the assistant manager. His defensive work on set-piece drills has earned him the nickname of the Tower, and he has also been shining in open play. Clips have emerged of the gangly centre-half waltzing through his teammates and scoring deftly, and Leanders confirmed that the Cameroonian has been impressive. he was awarded Player of the Tournament in a straight rules competition where teams had to earn the right to stay on through judged performances. This was perhaps Leijnders' most far-reaching diary entry to date, and he also had fascinating remarks on Arrigo Sacchi. Work on the pressing side of the game and the importance of having Van Dijk's vocal leadership back. Seeing the depth and intensity of the work being put in, it is hard not to feel optimistic about the new campaign for Liverpool.